All right, so this is your pick. Why? I want an actual answer.
All right, I'll give you an actual answer. It is because superhero movies are currently in a boom. Came out making fun of these movies during a time before these movies were everywhere. So I'm really curious to see how this movie that doesn't hold up holds up in that context as well.
Isn't it mostly a Spider-Man parody?
Kevin Hart?
Oh my God, I didn't know that.
Brent Spiner?
We have a new candidate for the worst Kevin Hart movie now. Wait, that's actually really funny.
Harvey Weinstein!
What? That's a good joke, too.
You know what? I will give them this. I think they did very good casting Drake Bell. He looks like Ned's Declassified.
This guy blew up after this
Kevin
movie.
Hart looks so old still.
Man, 2008 for superhero movies. Iron Man, The Dark Knight, superhero movie.
It flew away.
And left a smoke trail.
It isn't on fire on the ground. Oh, bully time.
What the F, loser?
Yep. The F, loser.
What is he in? That guy.
Children.
Daryl Dickinson in Thelma and Louise. He's in Happy Gilmore. He's in The Iron Giant as Kent Mansley.
Riker.
He's the president in Spy Kids 2.
That's yes, what it he is. Is.
That's the thing you know from everything I've said. That's the thing that spots
Spy Kids 2 is great.
Oh, right into the perfectly accented pieces of poop.
They look like the emojis for poop just placed onto the screen.
Do you not have two shirts on? Or you got the jacket. Just zip the jacket up.
This was released in theaters?
Allegedly.
Why didn't it want to mate with him like the rest?
Oh
my God.
How was that bottle not very secured?
That's
what
CGI.
What the fuck?
That means that some VFX animator had to animate the squirrel humping his shoe for like months before this movie
Take
came out.
Take it all, bitch.
Yo, Kevin, Harvey Weinstein definitely fucking produced this movie. He actually looks like Uncle Ben, too.
Well, just in the same clothes.
He could just be Uncle Ben. Like he's just.
Did I send you guys the gif of Peter coming down the stairs and somebody edited it so he kicks Uncle
Yes!
Ben in the face?
I've waited long enough for this egomaniac. We're the board of directors. Our time is valuable.
Not as valuable as mine, Mr. Carlson.
I've been waiting for you to storm over.
Crazy is hearing voices, talking to cats, dating Paula Abdul.
Ah, of course. Paula Abdul.
Hot, fresh reference for 2008, Paula Abdul.
I don't even know who Paula Abdul is.
This guy kind of reminds me of, like, Vince McMahon?
Please just hard cut to somebody going out the window.
No, that's too expensive. They got a punch in on this guy. I'll say this. I thought this would be a zero. It's not.
It's not good, but it's not
it's
a zero.
It's not good at all.
Google!
Oh, if it says he has cancer, it's going up a whole point. Oh, 2008, Britney Spears. Yep, there you go.
You ever had sexual intercourse?
Checks over his
I
shoulder.
I can't let the computer know I'm gay.
There's one option. Okay, I'm a virgin.
What a loser. Facebook.
Iron Man came out the same year and had MySpace as a thing.
Yeah.
There are some things in this movie that are actually fucking hilarious.
She's wearing dental floss for underwear.
That's also funny. They should have had Eddie Redmayne.
I am not depressed because I have the gift of knowledge. That's a lie. I think about suicide every-
Jesus.
Wait, that's so fucked up.
Same, Stephen Hawking.
Type your own asses, and then, there's all the sex.
I think this bit was funny.
Yeah, and then
it went on way too long.
They dragged it way out. Holy CGI.
Peter did it practically.
What? Uh-oh. Dragonflies don't do that.
Yeah, they stick to things like spiders.
No, they don't, really.
They build webs, and they catch flies. Ugh, don't that recreate that shot, please.
That looks way grosser than it did in Spider-Man. Oh my God, he just killed that kid. This is just Spider-Man 1.
I think Jake just wanted to watch Spider-Man 1.
You could have just said Spider-Man 1, Jake.
Shit.
Maybe a lot of these sequences are starting funny.
And then just dragging out way too long. Do you think it's because the movie's so short they needed it to fill the runtime, so they just kept on the same
jokes? Yeah, if we cut out all the padding, it'd be, 20 minutes.
But if it was that 20 minutes you're describing, it'd be actually a pretty funny 20 minutes is the thing.
Get out of the way! No brakes!
No brakes? Why would you not have brakes?
Your truck would still naturally slow down.
Those people should be dead. That's car crash shrapnel. And why didn't this airbag deploy?
There's no brakes or airbag.
Where did all the shrapnel come from? That truck looks mostly intact.
How did you do there?
It's easier than it looks.
All right, Leslie Nielsen's great, as always. $20.
$30. Oh, I was close.
Huh. Jake, you could buy your
Nissan shitbox.
Two girls.
One cup. Yep.
That was hip and relevant.
Ah, pop-ups. Remember pop-ups, guys?
Yeah, they still happen.
They still happen.
He's a teenager applying for a car loan? Bullshit.
This is kind of like Spider-Man 2. Okay, so they're going a little all over the place.
This isn't god-awful.
Yeah, I thought it'd be way the fuck worse. I've seen Starving Games.
Nice rubber mask. What is this, Hitman?
every compliment I give the movie, it immediately rescinds it next scene.
Hey, Jeffrey Tambor.
I have an impacted colon.
You can see what's inside because that is actually transparent, just like him.
I'm nothing but a screw-up.
Yes, your life has been a testament to that.
It's like me talking to me.
My name is Professor
Xavier. Oh, look at that insert shot.
Born with their powers.
That might be the best joke in the whole fucking movie. Shit.
Alright, the scene only gets better.
Alright, Chiefs. Okay. I'm in there.
The second it stopped being a shot-for-shot Spider-Man ripoff, it got pretty funny.
Why would that be the suit? That's not your power.
Getting more and more feminine.
You know what's really funny? Drake Bell could have actually been Spider-Man at this time.
He looks younger in this than Tobey Maguire did in 2000.
Ooh. That looks awful.
Sorry, my bad.
All right, that scene. See, remember the funny scene in the X-Mansion?
Yeah.
And then this scene.
This just in, Tom Cruise is dead.
What? Yay!
You're a genius.
Wikipedia.
I'm amazed that some of these website gags have held up.
Yeah.
Well, they're all websites still. Wikipedia.
Yeah, but they're still
Facebook,
all very well-known websites.
Yeah,
like, there's a MySpace joke in Iron Man.
Well, one of them's fucking Google, Mud.
Uh-oh.
Oh, please don't go just back to Spider-Man 1.
I want that story on my desk or you're fired!
You, good sir, are a terrible J.K. Simmons impression.
I know the mayor of Venus! Hamburgers can see the future! Rosie!
Oh, it's new version of J.K. Simmons' J. Jonah from Spider-Man Far From Home.
Where'd he go?
It's even like just playing the Spider-Man soundtrack.
Oh, they did that thing that universities do where they spell the U like a V, so it's the Bavilding.
Oh no.
Not a costume.
I am the Hourglass!
No, you're a Transformer.
When's Marvel gonna buy this property too and make a movie out of him?
Dude, Drake Bell in the MCU?
Don't even reboot it, just a sequel to this.
It's over, Hourglass.
No, Dragonfly.
It's just begun. Don't say it, please.
It's just begun!
Oh my god! Wait, this guy's written good movies. That's the thing.
What's he written?
Epic movie, disaster movie, date movie?
No, Hangover Part 2? Never mind, he hasn't made any good movies.
I've only seen Drake Bell playing the cool guy, but now he's playing Josh from Drake and Josh.
I have also seen him be Timmy Turner in the hit movie.
Oh god.
Why did you watch that?
I can sense Ian's next dealer choice
recommendation. No, god no. I want to watch something
Drake
good.
Drake Bellathon.
Oh shit.
What?
Get it, Jake? Because he said, oh shit.
Why would he say the street names out loud?
Because it's a visual gag, Jake.
It doesn't make it funny.
Fight choreography sucks.
It sucks so bad they keep cutting back to her looking at it.
You can see the wall moving.
I've seen that porn. Remember the paperclip guy?
Hot, fresh, topical reference once again.
You'll think it's ridiculous, but
it's the Drake Bell.
Why is every scene just Spider-Man, man? It's a superhero movie. They did X-Men, did a Batman thing, the Fantastic Four are in here.
This is kind of why, one of the reasons I picked it. What material did they have to work with? They had the Spider-Mans, some of the X-Mens.
Batman
is like iconic from
And
prior.
That's it. And
that's
they've
it.
Run the gambit.
We fucking blow.
Yeah.
Yes, it does.
Oh my god, this scene's gone on too long already.
That's the kind of thing. Like, it was kind of funny with the sprinkler, and now, what?
Some Scooby-Doo bullshit.
Well, it's the same gag over and over again.
A bike messenger knocked me down.
Wait, oh, Joseph same... Gordon-Levitt.
And you have a cut on your lip.
I'm gay.
My crack pipe broke.
Heroin addict.
Met a girl on Craigslist.
I...
Met a guy on Craigslist.
Guy on Craigslist.
Wow, man.
He's a gay heroin addict. He's using our excuses.
You know the dragonfly?
He's the guy I met on Craigslist.
It's before Iron Man when it was okay to reveal your secret identity.
That's not funny.
You know fart jokes?
No, oh, boy, do funny. I. They've never been funny. Oh my god. Zero.
You get it? It's because she's farting.
Oh, now she's flipping over and
she's gonna
shit
rock it.
In their mouth.
Alright, this is detracting multiple points from the movie. It's 21 minutes.
That one was me.
Why wouldn't they just move?
They didn't have the budget to actually move it, so they just had everyone reacting.
Like a lot of scenes in this movie.
I'm telling you this for your own good.
Looks like the hand is superimposed.
I don't love you.
Probably because that shot didn't have the hand in it. And they added that gag after the fact with the glove, so they had to comp in a hand. I'm guessing here, but that looked a lot like the same shot before it cut.
This is just bad Spider-Man. It's also slightly funnier than Spider-Man, though.
I mean, Spider-Man was pretty fucking funny. We're undercutting how funny that first Sam Raimi movie was.
And the second one.
And the second
and
one.
The third one.
The third one with funny.
You'll get this rent when you fix your damn door! What the fuck is that?
I thought that was Ashton Kutcher.
Well, that shortcut through the playground sure saved us some time.
I love listening to some.
Most of the points we're gonna give this movie are just him.
Take him down! Okay, the Pope taking a photo of the Dalai Lama's dick's funny. Is that Desmond Tutu? That's a good reference. That's a deep cut.
Yeah.
Damn.
This will help you forget.
It really is Harvey Weinstein.
Oh my god. Wait. 2008 Comic-Con? Hollywood still thought that nerds liked superheroes and not actual cool people.
There's even the girl dressed as a superhero when she's just wearing like her corset and underwear.
Ah, it looks so good.
Holy green screen.
You're gonna almost see the wires.
What if they just die?
This movie got many points if they just die.
What looked better, those fake wings or the fake wings in the Flash and Arrow episode we just watched?
The ones in Jupiter Ascending, though.
Oh, speaking of Jupiter Ascending, Eddie, you're here.
As long as there's crime and injustice,
literally any other superhero will take care of it.
All right.
Out of 10.
Well, you go last because it was your pick.
Like
so,
a 2?
Yeah, I'm feeling like a 2.
That sucked ass. But it was, like, kind of funny sometimes.
I don't know if I'm 1 or 2 right now. I'm one somewhere between those numbers. But the reason I picked it was because I'm shocked that this was made at a time when there were barely superhero movies.
Well, just because there was barely any doesn't mean they weren't talked about a lot. The Spider-Man trilogy was, like, one of the biggest fucking movies of all time back when it was out.
But Spider-Man got nominated and won an Oscar.
I get that, but, like, if you contrast that with the decade after this, where we have 5 or 6 a year.
You know, no one knew that was coming.
Exactly. So
it's
at
the time this movie came out, Spider-Man was hot. Exactly. Like, red fucking hot.
I'm looking at this as, like, a time capsule of, like, this is what the parody of... Like, this is a parody of what the culture of superhero movies was then.
Yeah.
So...
That's true.
I'm so curious to see something like this, even if it's terrible, be made today, and to see what they do with it.
Yeah.
Because all we've gotten is Deadpool, and that's actually really good. You know what I mean?
Well, it's not even that. Deadpool is still a superhero movie while being a parody. This isn't.
Yeah.
If we had like a straight up like shitty parody of all the superhero movies.
Superhero Tubi.
Yeah. Shut up. Sorry.
That's a great title.
It is. It's not a sequel though, so it'd be the superhero movie.
It's a reboot.
Yeah. It's a reboot.
With all that out of the way. So, Ian, what are you picking?
Picking a movie that I love.
Oh.
Right?
Mud Run.
It's an old school movie.
Yep.
So I have a few movies from back in the day, some classics that I love. And this is...
Shrek.
No, oh my god. Eventually it's coming, but not yet. Mud, you're not going to be happy. Everyone else in the room is going to be happy. You don't like the book. It's The Outsiders, because it's actually fantastic.
I fucking hate The Outsiders.